What you just saw was my edit of a developer video. If you would like to see the original, the link is down in the description. Welcome everybody to Indie Developer Spotlight, the series where I shine a light on tiny developers that send me their games. For today's spotlight, we're going to be talking about Hostile Takeover, another very early game that's being worked on by one person. Now just to be clear, he has admitted that he is using bot assets. There's nothing wrong with that, okay? Just so long as you admit that you're using bot assets and not saying that it's, you know, made in-house. Because you would be stealing it at that point. Now we'll just have to see how he uses them. So after about 6,500 hours in Arma 3, he got the idea to make a game, but he basically knew nothing about the Unreal Engine. This game has been in production for well over a year, and he says that it's been really trial and error, but he stayed dedicated, pumping several hundreds of dollars into buying assets. The core of the game is to be a co-op multiplayer game, and he told me that he was basically 40% done with all the mechanics that will be in the game. Now in the game, he says that you are an operator in the private sector, taking on government covert operations. The gameplay itself allows for you to solve missions in a variety of ways. The missions can actually drag out pretty long, so it forces the player to actually eat and drink. The game will have you do missions in multiple locations around the world. Then the developer talks about how bullet projectiles are going to work in the game. He describes it as being as real as you can get it. If you get hit in the head, you're dead. If you get shot in places like your arm, you'll take a percentage of damage. He said that it should only take two shots, a shot to the stomach and a shot to the head, to really kill you. Arms and legs, not so much. There are different strengths to each weapon that you decide to use. Some weapons are more powerful than others, and I'm guessing that goes the same for bullet type. And yes, there is going to be a medical system where you can actually heal yourself out on the battlefield, although how it's going to work is a little unknown right now, but it definitely will be in the game. He says that there's going to be characters in the game, Misty, Cobra, Daybreaker, to name a few. According to the developer, these characters are from different countries, and because they're from those countries, they all have different quirks. Those quirks being whatever gun that country uses the most is the gun that these characters are going to be more in tune with, if that makes sense. Like the United States' main weapon is the M4, so Americans are mostly going to be in tune with the M4, if that makes any sense. You'll still be able to customize your guy and use whatever weapon that you want, but just know that your guy is more in tune with like the M4, so he might have a little bit of trouble with his weapons on the field. At least that's how I think he was trying to portray it. He's Norwegian, so he was using Google Translate to try and tell me all of this. I'm trying to make sense of this, but I think that's how he wanted to describe it, I think. Then he talks about AI. He says that you'll be able to interact with them, and there's going to be some sort of intimidation tactics that you can use to persuade them to do things. What you do will decide whether they die or give up. The intimidation tactic can also be used to have enemies give up crucial information. Intimidation is apparently used as experience, if I'm reading this right. Again, this could be getting lost in Google Translation, but I believe that's what this says. He released a video that kind of showcases this, and it's actually pretty interesting. Just imagine, you're in the woods and you go up to like a random village and you can talk to the locals to get some type of information. At least that's how I'm picturing this. My understanding is that he actually has some voice actors lined up for, testing, so we'll see how that goes. Then he talks about a recoil system, saying that for each weapon, it's going to vary, but I'm sure some attachments will negate most of the recoil. Speaking of attachments, he's currently working on ways to make it so that you could completely customize your character, look through all the gear and all that kind of stuff. Send me a few pictures and I'm showing them on the screen right now. The developer described an interesting movement system. When you're aiming down sights and you're moving, you'll obviously move slow, but pressing down the Alt button will make the player move even slower, but you'll be able to hone in on your target even better. He says that you're going to be able to walk, jog, sprint, you know, simple stuff. I then asked if the game is going to have a stealth system, to which the developer replied, yes, there is going to be stealth in the game. Missions will allow you to take down bad guys stealthily. Interesting. I had asked if he had any inspirations from any other games, and he said games like Arma, Swat, Battlefield 3 and 4, and the original Rainbow Six games really has an impact on the game that he has now. That's actually a pretty big mishmash of games, if I do say so myself. I can't wait to see what this game actually looks like in the future. Hopefully this game gets more funding and more people helping him work on it. And that's pretty much all I got to say about this game. What do you guys think about Hostile Takeover? Does it interest you? Or maybe it's just not your thing. Either way, if you want to check them out, their links are down in the description to all their media sites. And that's pretty much it. I want to thank everybody for coming out to watch, and I guess I'll catch you in the next one. Bye-bye.